Bonjour my lovelies, how are you today? Oh my gosh, I wanted to do this video for a very long time because it did help me. 8 fashion tips to be a smart shopper. So this video is for you if you believe that you spend too much money shopping, if you buy clothes that actually do not fit you at all, or it's not your style, or you come back home, you're trying, you're like, then this video is for you. If you're new to my channel, I am Frederic. I talk about beauty, fashion, lifestyle with a French twist, and you are more than welcome in my lovely community. Please show me your love just by doing one thing. It's free. It takes one click, 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 click. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for being here. All of you, my lovelies, give me a big thumbs up. If you do not follow me on social media, please do, especially on Instagram, MS Frederic. Plus on Pinterest is exactly the same handle, and have a look on my Pinterest account because I'm going to talk about Pinterest as well in this video. And let me know at the end of this video, only at the end, please watch to the end because I really work hard to prepare those points because it's all based on my experience as a shopper, especially now I got a fashion channel, it's like, ooh, challenging. So please let me know in comments, what is your tip to be a smart shopper and still feel like you can buy new trends, new clothes regularly? I would love to know. So the first one I will recommend is to stop buying clothes with nylon, polyester, viscose. It's not easy because now most of the clothes have it, and especially if you're like me, if you go to a shop and we like a garment, we barely check inside exactly the composition. I love buying online for the reason because I'm always going to source information and I look exactly at the composition. If there's something I don't like, I don't like it, I don't buy it. Rather to get more clothes with recycled cotton called lyocell, it's fantastic. Bamboo, obviously cotton, I just said, linen or a blend linen. And what else? And silk. I think that's the type of fabrics will last for a very long time if you take care of it, and it's so much better for your skin, and it's just a better feel. And wool, obviously, cashmere, etc. Number two is to avoid to buy cheap clothes. The only good point of cheap clothes, okay, is that you can buy a lot for a reasonable amount. But you know you didn't pay a good price for that. And I don't blame you, so I don't have always the money to buy clothes, you know, I'm always setting up my budget, which I'm gonna talk about it. But what I'm talking about it is when it's really cheap, when it's really easy to wear the fast fashion, that you can really be more careful now with your decision about that, they are not going to last for a long time. You're gonna put them in a washing machine, it's gonna be a nightmare for some to iron. Again, it's coming back to my point number one about polyester, viscose, nylon. But I will recommend to buy less clothes and better quality with all the fabrics I already named it. You don't need a ton of clothes. You don't need as well 3 garments. I mean, if you do, lucky you, but I'm not. But you need the basic. You need maybe do a list as well. I know, for example, I have a couple of garments I want to buy for the new season, but mainly right now I'm building my capsule for years, and slowly I'm getting a little bit more picky, I would say, with the type of quality of clothes, and so I'm buying a bit less and better quality. I'm trying, but don't forget, I'm having this fashion channel, so if I get rid of all the viscose and nylon and polyester, I will probably do the video naked as well, which might be a new concept. I'm kidding, obviously. Okay, number 3, don't be an impulse buyer. Ooh. We all are being guilty of this, okay? So, for example, you're online and you see something, and they always do that because they push you to buy. I got a newsletter on Sunday, said 15% before Sunday night, blah, blah, blah. And I know the clothes are not good quality. And I'm like, and I'm still tempted because it's marketing. Marketing works very well. If you like something online, I will recommend to create a wish list and you sleep on it. Even sometimes I'm waiting for a week. And then I review the clothes again. If they're gone, they're gone. And I'm like thinking, is it still worth it? I'm looking in my wardrobe, I'm like, do I need 3 different tanks? Do I need those colors, etc. And this forced me, this little walk and little fight with my conscience, just not to be an impulse buyer anymore, because most of the time when I buy and I realize it's so not my style, even the clothes looks beautiful, that's not the issue, it's just like, it doesn't fit me. Number 4, try before buying. I know this is a bit tricky because we buy more and more online. If you buy, for example, a brand like you know very well, you know the true size, then it's not gonna be an issue. So think about it. But for something more expensive, like a cashmere or like a coat, I would prefer to see the garment in the shop. Just for the little story, we're in COVID, it's been very difficult for a lot of us to go shopping. And when we want to go shopping and you're ready to spend a bit of money, they put a lockdown and you stay at home and you're frustrated. And then you want to go online and buy it. But for something a little bit more expensive, my recommendation will be go to the shop. Be patient a little bit more and try. Try the code, try this because, you know, or unless you don't care, you buy online and you have a very good return policy. I find that annoying personally to return items, but sometimes, you know, when it doesn't suit, period. Number 5, avoid fast fashion. And I know when you're gonna say, but Zara is fast fashion. But I will say mainly those brands like Boohoo, Shein, I don't know the other one in the state. Here we don't have a lot of brand and it's hard sometimes. And I will say that if I'm interested in something with H&M, I will try to go to the conscious, I think it's called conscious category. And as well now with Zara, they tell you the history of the clothes. They tell you they spend a lot of time to give you description of the recycled cotton and things like that. And I know personally as a buyer, I will be more inclined to buy something that is better for the environment, is better that is being treating people well, etc. If you want to buy completely sustainable, good for you, but sometimes can be very expensive and it's not available in every countries. But fast fashion, you don't have to look fashionable every week. Remember the rule, 80% basic, classic, good quality, 20% trends, fashion trends. Number 6, when I say buy less and better quality, sometimes we are too tempted and sometimes it's not even your fault. Suddenly your phone is like alerts everywhere, you check your emails, you got like newsletter, then it's time to decline. It's time to unsubscribe those newsletters, especially the one who reminds you like 5-6 times per day. That's driving me absolutely crazy. Just keep the newsletter that or the brand that you're really interested in, you know, maybe 2-3, I don't know. I'm not gonna give you a number because that's totally your personal choice. But I'm trying to stay away of those Boohoo or Shein because I tried with Shein once. They never ever stop bombarding me. I got like emails every day, 2-3 times per day, and that absolutely killed my buzz. And I'm like, I'm not interested. I'm really not interested. Even if you can check your email preferences, but just be in control and don't be a fashion victim. And you don't have to, you are the one decided, oh, this is good. You are the one decided when you're gonna buy what you really need and not really going to tell you, hey, buy this, buy that, buy this. Because they're smart right now, they're really smart. Number 7, shop small. Unless you have a big wardrobe to redone, but even if you do that, I will go easy. Just make a list of what you need. For example, I know I need a couple of jeans, I need a couple of shorts and linen, I need a black pants linen. Actually, you can check on my Pinterest because I do those mood board. And what else do I need? I need a couple of swimmers for this summer coming in, but it's not so much, you know, and I'm probably gonna buy a couple of linen items and shirts because I wear them all the time. But the best way for you is to ask yourself before you buy, do I need this outfit? Ask yourself if this item can be matched with your other outfit in colors, in type of things you're wearing. And just ask yourself, do I really need it? Or do I have already 10 black tanks. This is what happened with me this morning. I'm like, oh, I need to buy a new. I'm like, I got already so many. Are you insane? And learn from your mistake. This is my point number 8. We all made mistakes. We all spend way too much money in clothes that isn't worth it. We all buy clothes that sometimes it's like, oh, they don't have your size, they have just underneath, and you're like, I'm gonna lose a bit of weight because I really love it. You never lose the weight, you never wear the items. Personally, I never had clothes in my wardrobe with the tags on. That's not gonna happen. Soon I buy something, I like washing it and trying, and I feel good, and I'm like, oh, I can do this overhead fit. But again, it's due with my job, which is the fun part of it. But learn and be smart with your money. And another point as well, when you're creating your wish list, when you're creating your mood board, it forces your mind to take time. And as well, I will recommend you to set up a budget per month, because that's gonna help you to be a smart shopper, ladies. If your budget is $300 per month, less or more, doesn't matter the amount, then don't spend more. If you spend a little bit less, then save the extra for the future months. You don't have to. This is what I do, obviously. Set up a budget, so like this, you're not feeling overwhelmed at the end of the month. You realize you spend way too much. You're gonna regret it. And even if the clothes looks fantastic, it doesn't gonna make you feel good inside. And that's not healthy. All right. Don't forget to tell me in comments what is your tip to be a smart shopper. Don't tell me it's not shopping, because that's not smart. Please don't forget to subscribe. I click, 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 click. I just put lipstick on my hands. Exactly what I wanted to avoid. I give you a big kiss. Thank you so much again for watching. I see you to the next video. Take care. Bye bye.